Could Kamala Harris be out as the Vice President of the United States? Are we talking about a confirmation hearing for a new Vice President? What is going on? We'll get into all the details of it and much more in great detail in just a second, guys. First, if you could, please like this video, share it, hit the bell, subscribe, or wear the glasses because I'm blind. Also, if you could, consider making a generous donation to our ministry. We're demonetized on YouTube. They don't support us. You guys can help us out in a major way through PayPal or Patreon. For $5 a month, you'll get bonus content. We also include the links for the YouTube videos so you get all alerts when new content arrives. Another thing, we put up Rumble exclusives there as well on our Patreon. Those are links that'll get you direct access to videos on Rumble you will not find here on YouTube. So go sub to me on Rumble, guys. All those links are down below. A big thank you to everybody already contributing, and for those thinking of doing so, thank you as well. Your generosity greatly appreciated. So this report came out. You had Fox News congressional reporter Chad Pergram. Now, he was on actually several different Fox programs. He was on a podcast with Bret Baier. Then he actually spoke on Jesse Waters' show. And he was talking about a tip that he received a couple of weeks ago from a source that works within the White House that said, Chad, you should start to familiarize yourself with the confirmation process of a vice president. That being how it works in the House and the Senate, because a vice president needs confirmation from both the House and the Senate. And he thought this was kind of strange. Now, this goes along with another big report that came out over the weekend that Biden was reportedly looking into nominating Harris to the Supreme Court to get rid of her in line here of the succession. Well, if you were to believe those rumors and the fact that, well, it's not a rumor, I guess when you look at her poll numbers, as low as they are, she's probably the most, if not, well, probably, yeah, the most unpopular vice president that we've ever had. And then you could just put Biden right there with the most unpopular president that we have ever had as well. But a nomination to the Supreme Court to get rid of her, just shuffling her on out. Look, I mean, there is no doubt the Democrats are looking at this current team here and they're worried. They're looking at 2024. Who are we going to have as our candidate to run against whoever the Republican nominee is? Because there's no doubt whoever it is, whether it's Trump or DeSantis, is going to be a lot better than either Biden or Harris will be. But if you get rid of Harris now and you replace her with, who knows? I mean, I don't know. I mean, that I don't know. There's no names floating around right now. Maybe they have some internally that they're looking at here. I don't think this would be so much about, you know, who would be Biden's running mate in 2024. I think that whoever this new VP pick would actually be who they want the president to be, because I don't see Biden making it past 2022. I think that's what this is all about here. Even a report said that Jill Biden was looking into using the 25th Amendment to get rid of Harris. I mean, they should use the 25th Amendment to get rid of Biden, but they're looking into that as a possibility to get rid of her, blaming, you know, mental deficiencies and everything else like that. Now, they could just turn right around and use that on Biden as well to get him out. And then, you know, you get the new, you know, vice president, whoever in there. I mean, it'd be like a total House of Cards situation here, like that Netflix show, right? That's what it looks like here. So dissension, dissension, dissension is the word here. The Democrats are crumbling, I think, in light of what happened in Virginia with Glenn Youngkin becoming governor. And I think they know in 2022, if things are allowed to, you know, be played out fairly, the Republicans are going to dominate the midterms. And so they need a stronger, you know, candidate, a representative for their party if they want any chance at all of winning in 2024. This is going to be an interesting situation, an interesting story to follow as it plays out. This is no doubt a corrupt administration. And they're all going at each other. You know, it's just that they're all fighting each other. It's kind of funny to watch it all happen and play out. But it's important to note that as this is all happening and we look at them going at each other, Christians, as Christians, we cannot just put our faith in any political leader. We might look at this and say, oh, this is great. This dissension, now Trump can get back in or DeSantis can get in. Even if that does happen, if one of them does, we still have to look to the Lord, because he's the only one that we can fully put our trust in. There is no political candidate that can save this country. Only Jesus Christ can save us, and only Jesus Christ can save your soul. It's why we do these videos. We talk about prophetic news headlines going on around the world as we're trying to reach people to Jesus Christ. Maybe that's you right now. You have yet to make that decision to accept Christ into your life. I would love to lead you in a prayer right now to get you to do that. You can put this prayer in your own words, but I'll give you the steps that you need to bring it before the Lord today. The first thing that you want to do, for some it's the most difficult, but we all are, is to acknowledge that you're a sinner. The good news is this. God gave his only son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross for the sins of all the world. He died and rose again for you and me. He paid the cost. What you have to do is repent of that sin. Repent means to turn from sin, not just to say you're sorry, but to turn from lifestyles, habits, whatever it is in your life that goes against the word of God. You ask Jesus to forgive you. He'll wipe that sin away. The Bible says he won't remember it any longer. And then you invite Jesus into your life to be your Lord and Savior. When you do that, you become born again, a child of God. You will have eternal life. Trust me when I tell you there is no greater decision that you will ever make than the one you do to give your life to Christ. I pray that you make that decision today. I'll have more for you guys on this down below, including a couple of video clips for you. Don't forget the links to donate to our ministry are there as well. It is a great blessing if you could help us out. Thank you all so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. I'll be back with more. You guys take care. Please be safe out there. God bless each and every single one of you, and I'll talk with you soon.